If you want to create a simple GraphQL API following the code-first approach using Nest.js, but you don't know where to start, in this Quick Tips episode, you will learn how. Keep watching! Hi there! I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start! In this video, I will show how to use Nest.js to create a GraphQL API for returning some quizzes with their titles and descriptions, and how to test the new API by using the GraphQL Playground and Postman. Nest.js is a framework for building server-side Node.js applications. If you don't have it already, just install the Nest.js CLI. Create the quizzes application using Nest New and the project's name. For adding support for GraphQL, change into the directory for our new app and install nest.js/graphql, GraphQL tools, GraphQL, and Apollo server. I will create a module for organizing all the code for our quizzes. Then, following the code-first approach, I will also create a simple quiz type with a title, description, and properties for specifying if we should shuffle questions or answers. A resolver that will define the queries and mutations that we are exposing. And finally, a service that will take care of getting the data from a database, or in this case, a JSON file. So first, let's create the quizzes module, where we'll organize our GraphQL queries and types related to a quiz. For the type, create a file named quiz.model.ts inside the quizzes folder. Import object type, field, and int from Nest.js GraphQL. Use the object type decorator and define the quiz type. Using the addField decorator, add properties for an ID of type int, also a title, description, and if questions or answers should be shuffled. Create the quizzes service that will be responsible for data storage and retrieval. Create a JSON file that will work as our database for the quizzes. Open the quizzes.service file, import the JSON file, and create a method to return its contents. On the tsconfig.json file, add resolve JSON module and set it to true. Create the GraphQL quizzes resolver using the Nest.js CLI. Open the quizzes resolver file. Add query to the imports, import the quiz object type and the quizzes service, add a constructor that receives the quizzes service, and expose a simple query that returns a list of quizzes. On the app.module.ts file, import the GraphQL module from nest.js/graphql, and configure it for auto-generating the schema. Finally, start the server. Go to localhost :3000/graphql, which will open the GraphQL playground inside your browser. On the left, type quizzes as the query to get the list of quizzes. Specify title as the field to be returned, and press the play button in the middle. As you can see, we got all the quizzes with their respective titles. You can also request the description or the other fields to be returned without modifying the server. Let's check this too using Postman. Create a new request, change it to post, type localhost colon 3000 / GraphQL for the URL. On body, switch to GraphQL, type the same initial query specifying title as the field to be returned as before and hit send. As you can see, we got a JSON response with the list of quizzes below data and their respective titles. You can also request the description, for example. And as you can see, the server only returns the specified fields and nothing more. In the next video, I will talk about adding child elements to our quiz object type. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.